Hey, I'm Ron Drotos from keyboardimprov.com, and welcome to the 18th video in our Complete Beatles Piano Series. This is with a little help from my friends. We're going to look at two different ways to play it and kind of combine them in a way that has eluded me for many, many years on this. This is one of my favorite Beatles tunes, and if you know it from their 1967 Sgt. Pepper album, it's kind of got this bouncy kind of chunk, 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 chunk. Like guitar and that sort of quarter note feel on the keyboards, and that's kind of a vibe that's throughout Sgt. Pepper. Paul McCartney really liked that quarter note feel, and he really popularized it. I mean, it appeared, I think Brian Wilson brought it a little earlier. Sgt. Pepper was a reaction to the Beach Boys album Pet Sounds, where Brian Wilson did this whole orchestral thing with all these different colors of the orchestra and some electronics as well. And it shocked the Beatles, and it said, oh, we have to try to up that, try to compete against that and do that even better. You know, they had this kind of friendly rivalry that inspired both groups to creativity, the Beach Boys and the Beatles. Paul McCartney's spoken of that. And I think he was very influenced by Brian Wilson and has acknowledged that, a big favorite of his. And that's where I think he got a lot of that. You hear it on songs like Fixin' a Hole, and then later on, ballads. Like, you know, this pop ballad style, like on Let It Be, where he's playing these basically quarter notes and then some eighths thrown in, which has now become the pop piano style 50 years later, right? The standard pop piano style. It all be traced back to Paul McCartney. He didn't invent it, right? Other people have done it. It's even in some classical music over the years, but he certainly popularized it. And it's become standard. So thank you, Sir Paul McCartney, for that. With a little help from my friends, now here's my personal dilemma with this. So the Beatles did it in this sort of chunk, 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 and it's probably the least bluesy song they ever recorded. I mean, it's got a nice swingy feel, certainly swing, but it's not really particularly bluesy, which is fine. Don't have to be bluesy all the time. Yet, a few years later, Joe Cocker did that slow bluesy version that, you know, it's like a one, two, three, a one, two, three. That gospel feel, that slow 12-8 feel, one and a two. It's so incredible, right? I love playing that style too. I've played gospel music in churches over the years. I love playing blues. Everything about that style appeals to me on piano, except for one thing. Personally, now this is just me, doesn't have to be you, I don't love this song being done like that. Something about the lyric, and maybe I'm just hearing the Beatles do it. I'm like, you know, as much as I you know, Joe, I'll be in the car and the Joe Cocker version will come on the classic rock station or something, and I'll listen to it a while and then, okay, wish this was the Beatles instead. I don't know. That's my sort of guilty pleasure, I guess. Musician's guilty pleasure is that even though I love blues and gospel, I love the Beatles version, which is not that better than the Joe Cocker, a lot better. So, but for this video, I was trying to think, well, you know, how can I play this? Because you know, it presents so many opportunities, right? Playing bluesy on the piano. So much fun, right? And if we're just going like this, it's nice, but it's not really making it my own, which is kind of the purpose of this. I want to show us how we can sort of make these songs our own and adapt them to the piano. So all of a sudden though, after weeks of thinking about this, that's what I do, it just occurred to me, I can play it in the tempo of the Beatles version, the medium tempo with this chunk chunk, but I can bring in a little bit of the bluesy version from the Joe Cocker. Never thought of that before, in actually years, decades, I've never thought of that. So I can go, so I can bring some of that into it. So that's where this is going. So I'm gonna start out, I'm going to do a bluesy introduction, not their introduction. I'm just going to play an E7 chord, the left hand, and a little blues scale thing. And then play an intro, 1, 4, and 5 chords, and then boom, get into the song. see where it takes us. But the Beatles groove, Joe Cocker's semi-gospel and certainly blues take on it. And hopefully give you some ideas. You can use the blues scale, you can use the major blues scale. You can just play some flat thirds, go into thirds, and go to town with it. Here we go. So I'm gonna start out of tempo. That was a lot of fun. And like I said, I've waited decades for that to click and say, okay, I can play that Beatles tempo with the bluesiness from the Joe Cocker version, which isn't my favorite version of the song, but I love playing that style, right? So thanks for being here for my sort of musician's therapy session where I kind of reconciled those two opposite, okay, I love the Beatles, but I want to play it like Joe Cocker, but where's the tempo? It seems so obvious in retrospect, at least now. So thanks for joining me here. If you're interested in taking your playing to a whole different level of fluency, check out my video course. We'll see you in the next video. Take care.